So I just pulled up to the gate with the doggy, going to meet him, and these are the signs. I am about to meet the Pyrenees dog we talked about last week. I'm pretty excited about it. Can't wait to see him. We are cold here today, guys. It's windy. Look how fluffy you are. Cold. Only a high of 55, and we've been dealing with some crazy winds today, which makes it worse. Don't laugh at us. You fluffies. What's doing?
Getting eggs.
How many eggs?
Nine.
Nice. When it's super cold, we give them more hay at night. Helps keep them a little bit warmer. Doesn't usually get this cold here, does it?
No.
We typically only feed them once a day, but they're getting more tonight because it's going to be chilly. It'll help keep them warm. So right now we're here picking up the dog, but he won't get in the truck. And he's about 150 pounds. So I'm parking in this parking lot by her house because she wants to take him on a walk. And maybe if he's not on his property, he'll feel better. And we got a friend that's going to come and help as a third person to get him in the truck. He's a big boy. So we got this beast home. He is absolutely the best behaved dog ever. So his previous owner did a really great job with him. We introduced him to the dogs. He didn't care at all. He is not concerned with them. He didn't even really care to sniff them. So we kept him in the house last night. Of course, I walked him around the yard just around the house. And he was curious, but he's just very well behaved. He's very calm. I just love him. He's awesome. So I'm going to introduce him to the goats here in just a second. So we'll take you guys along for that. He has not seen a goat before. And likewise, the goats have not seen the likes of him before. So this should be interesting to see. I'm not going to take him in the pens. Just take him around.
What?
What? So we're going to see how that goes.
He doesn't care, guys.
Look, I want to show you the goat.
Look. What is it? Those are goaties. Look. Hey. Look.
Well, he doesn't care. No aggression for sure. This is kind of how he acts. He just doesn't really care. The goats aren't as interested as I thought, so let's go see the older does.
What do you think? What do you think? A little bit.
season.
I scare her off. What do you think, May? Well, come here. Come here, May.
Even Lucky, check him out. He's not up on his fence right now. Here's Anna. What? What's going on, guys? What do you think, Fancy Feet? What is this thing? You guys don't care. What is it? Are you scared? You've never seen a goat. Don't be scared. It's not good. Okay, let's get...
Diddy.
A little bit. It's okay. More goat? Alright, so the good news is that there was no aggression. He's a very chill dog. He looked a little freaked out about him, though. He didn't know what they were. Still hoping he wants to be best friends with them eventually. Obviously, that's not something today that he's just going to be thrown in there. But we're just going to continue to walk him around. And, you know, hang out over here, walk him around here more and more often so that the goats aren't scared of him, or at least are familiar with him, and he's more familiar with them. So all in all, pretty good. He didn't really care about him, but he doesn't really care about much, so. He's a good boy. He's a good boy.
So as far as our garden update, took a little bit of a hurting with those few days of cold. We did cover some of the stuff. We told you we weren't going to cover the beans or the tomatoes or anything. So we didn't. Our tomatoes are pretty much done for. We did make some fried green tomatoes, so thank you guys for those comments, because we've had them before and I just completely didn't even think about it. So we did harvest some of them and ate good on those. But here, I'll show you guys. You know what I'm really shocked about is how good our peppers have done. We didn't cover them or nothing, and they're just... I thought they would take more of a wallop than the tomatoes, but they didn't. So these are our tomatoes. We still got some patches where they're still good, like these cherries here. They're still good. We'll see. We're not going to tear them out just yet, but yeah, for the most part, they're goners. Our beans, also a bit of goners. These ones, again, are, you know, put into seed, so they're doing right what they're supposed to be doing. These were good beans. Carrots, not affected at all. Not surprising. Cold weather. There's the beans. We still have all our flowers in here. We should take them out. As far as the lettuce, so this one, these two gardens, like I said, these are our the newest stuff that we have, and you know what we really wanted to keep. So we made like a little dome thing here, and that just folds up and down. So when it froze, we covered it. And that actually worked really well. So everything in here is doing really good still. And over here, just like you guys saw in the last video, we just kind of have these bricks and wood there so that we could cover it, but it wasn't touching anything. We just draped the plastic right over it. So anyway, everything in here is doing really good still, so feeling good about it. We still got food. Harvest a big old salad today. And check out our snow peas. All along the side over here and over in that top bed where we got potatoes. So those have all came up. Hey, Tin. So over here, obviously we're not covering these ones over here, and they're doing just fine. So they're all sprouting all the way up. Can't wait to be eating those. So if you guys want to see what the garden looked like right last week, right before the freeze, my son Darren, he actually got a really cool video. He's editing and uploading all of his own videos on his YouTube channel, which will be in the description below, of course. So check out that video and you'll see what the garden looked like before this last week of a little bit of a freeze. So anyway, that's the update on the garden. Still feeling pretty good about it considering it's almost Thanksgiving and we are still eating pretty good from the garden. We got a lot of stuff growing, so we knew we wouldn't have the tomatoes forever, but once they're gone, we'll be able to replant more. So it's been kind of a busy week, but I did get to go out and see my friend, actually. She was the one who let me know about Strider, which is what his name is. But we might name him something else. I'm kind of thinking Ryder. I really like the name Ryder, and it still sounds familiar. We kind of do that with the dogs that we've taken in that had previous owners. We rename them, but kind of also want to keep the same kind of name, especially since he's four. But he doesn't come to Strider. He doesn't come to anything. He just kind of, he's a really good dog, really obedient. More of a whistle or a, so I don't think it's going to affect him much if we do change the name. So we're thinking about it. We do have kind of a D theme, if you will. All of our dogs are named something that starts with a D. So We've been thinking about that too. But he's an awesome dog. The only thing I don't like about this dog is that I haven't had him my whole life. Quite literally, he is the best behaved dog I've ever owned. He's just so sweet, so gentle. You know, everything that we read up on, and we have been for quite some time, everything we've read up on about this dog, this breed, he's held true to it. So, you know, it's only day two. Look at him. He's sweet. And he loves me. So he's pretty cool. I love him. I love him. The goats. Check him out. They're still like, what in the world is that beast? He's gonna do really good here. He's gonna do really awesome. I'm just super excited about him. So lucky to find him. So this little guy has two more weeks with us, and then he's heading off to Florida. What do you think? What do you think? Heading off to Florida to meet your new ladies? Yeah. Sweet boy. What do you think, Lucky? He's coming a little closer to the fence. Like, he doesn't even look at the goats. He's more concerned with what's out there. Huh, mister? Huh. He's gonna be a good boy for you, Lucky. He'll make sure nothing gets you. You don't believe me. Nope. Still same with Anna. Luck, Buck. You don't even care I'm on your fence? Not with this doggy here. Funny.
He's the best dog.
So it's been a good week. It's been busy at work. I was able to go meet him, and you know, that went really well when we met. And then afterwards, the friend who actually let me know about him, I was able to go see her, and it had been a long time since I seen her, too long. So she's got a little sheep farm going now, which is pretty cool.
Same stinky yellow poop. Except that's why they dock tails.
Right, because
the tails
just
don't roll up like goats, and it just gets all over the place.
They're so skinny. Are these your babies? They're surprise babies? Super cute. Oh my goodness, they're so cute.
So that's the smallest boy that's in front of you. This is the girl, she's in the middle, and then the tallest boy is on the other side.
Two boys and one girl?
That's right.
Keeping that girl.
Yeah, we're keeping the girl.
Two to go and one to keep.
Yep. She's got quite a few sheep. Might have to buy some from her, but either way, it's been a good week and super happy with this dog, you guys. If you have livestock, I highly recommend the Great Pyrenees.
Thank you.